Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Python programming tutorial series. In today's video, we will be building a GUI calculator using PyQt5. This calculator will have a user-friendly interface and perform basic arithmetic operations. So let's dive right in. Let's start by importing the required modules and libraries. We import sys for system-related functionalities, qtcore and qtgui from PyQt5 for the GUI components, and decimal from decimal for accurate decimal calculations. Next, we create a class called calculator that inherits from qwidget. This class represents our calculator window. Inside the class, we set the window title and layout. We create an input field using the qlineEdit widget and configure it to be read-only and write-aligned. We set the initial value to 0 and add it to the layout. Now, let's create the calculator buttons. We define a list of lists called buttons to store the button labels. Then, we create the buttons using the QPushButton widget and connect them to the button click slot. We use a grid layout to arrange the buttons in rows and columns. We also assign a specific object name, calculator button or math button, to differentiate between regular and mathematical symbol buttons. After creating the buttons, we add them to the grid layout and add the grid layout to the main layout of the calculator window. For each button, we set its style, background color, and font size. To handle button clicks, we define the button click slot. Inside this slot, we retrieve the text of the clicked button and perform different actions based on the text. For example, if the button text is equal sign, we evaluate the current expression and display the result in the input field. If there is a syntax error or division by zero, we display an error message. If the button text is C, we clear the input field and reset the current value. For buttons with numeric values, we handle the input and update the input field accordingly. We also handle special cases, such as skipping leading zeros and preventing consecutive symbols. If the last pressed button was equal sign, we handle numeric input as a new expression. We add additional functionality like division, multiplication, subtraction, plus minus toggle, and percentage calculation. These operations are handled by calling the SIMDUP function. Finally, we create an instance of the calculator class, set the window background color, and display the calculator window. And that's it. We've successfully built a GUI calculator using PyQt5 in Python. Feel free to customize the styles and colors to match your preferences. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. You can find the complete code in the video description below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more Python programming tutorials. Thank you for watching, and happy coding!